I think there's a lot of issues that have been come out in the press that actually are not accurate. And let me just make a couple of points. One is that there are statements being made that somehow the United States agreed to the exact, we negotiated or somehow signed on to the idea of reducing our staff. We were told to do that. That was not something that was negotiated. That's number one. Number two, the Russian government reduced, used as its argument, reducing our staff so that we could have parity. And we said, okay, that's the, if that's what you're going to do, all right. And then when, but when we used parity to reduce the, to withdraw our consent for the Russian government to have a consulate in San Francisco, then everyone got all excited. And, you know, parity is parity. So that's where we are. Number two, number three, there's a lot of issues that have been thrown around out there that that the United States was putting pressure, that we were knocking down doors and we were making life. It's just not true. What happened was that in on Saturday, which was after the time that that the consulate in San Francisco was due to go back, the United States, with Russian embassy personnel, walked through the consulate general in San Francisco. It took place, as I said, while the properties were still considered part of the embassy or consular premise. And these inspections were carried out to protect the facilities and to confirm that the Russian government had vacated the premises. Nobody broke down doors. Nobody put undue pressure on people. It was all done very, very carefully. And a lot of the, and in compliance with the Vienna Convention. A lot of stories have gone around out there that are just simply not true.